So the violence in Kenosha, Wisconsin is out of control now. And I just want to say, this is the Democrat utopia. To all my friends that I know and acquaintances, when I put a video out months ago saying that Trump should send in the National Guard, and you called people behind my back and said, is Rob a dictator? Is Rob an authoritarian? Why would we want to send in police? Why would we want to send in National Guard? This is exactly why I said I wanted to do it. It was with a heavy heart. I didn't want to see the National Guard sent in. But when we have Democratic governors and mayors that want their cities to burn because they perceived it as hurting Donald Trump, that was the bad choice that needed to be made. There was no positive choice. The best choice was sending in the National Guard to make sure law and order was restored. You said that that made me a terrible person, and now we see exactly what I said would happen. Armed vigilantes now shooting people that were rioting and protesting. I don't want to see anyone die, even those that are communist, even those that are domestic terrorists, that are using political violence to intimidate people for political reasons. I don't want to see them die, and that's exactly what we're going to see. And then as a result of tonight, we'll see that these Antifa BLM people will now arm themselves even more, and it'll be more blood and warfare on the street because you cheered for these riots, or you deflected for them, or you said they were mostly peaceful protests. Well, now people are dying, and this is what the Democratic Party wanted. Those people that said I was terrible for wanting police to do their job or for wanting the National Guard, this was the predictable result. Was it worth the virtue signaling you did? Was it worth it? Did you feel good telling your Facebook friends how virtuous you were because you didn't see a problem with the rioting? You didn't see anything going on? Are those deaths worth it to you? I hope so. Now all of a sudden we see that the internal polling is starting to show that, it turns out most people don't like these riots. Most people are sick and tired of it. Now we see people like Don Lemon and the Democrats start to say, oh yeah, we need to do something about the riots. Don't believe it. This is what they wanted. When they thought that it hurt Donald Trump, they were all for blood on the streets. They were all for burning down businesses. They were all for attacking people for their race. That's what they were for. Now they're going to pretend that they are saddened by this. Don't either they're lying and they're not saddened by it, or they're so ignorant that they couldn't see the predictable results that when you back people in a corner and you allow their businesses and their livelihood to be destroyed over and over and over, like the riots we've seen all across this country, that eventually they'll arm themselves and prevent this from happening. This blood is on the hands of the Democrats. This blood's on the hand of every single person that said ACAB, of every person that said, we don't want police, things will be okay. This is what you get. You get vigilante justice, and there's just the beginning of it. It's going to get worse and worse. Only force will stop the mob that is rioting and burning down all of these cities. If the government won't use the justified force that would be the best response, then people will take it into their own hands. Again, I don't want to see anyone get hurt, but if you're burning down people's property, this is what's to be expected. I also thought that it was sad and ironic at the same time that the first person that was shot in the head that probably won't make it, everyone started screaming, call the police. A bunch of people rioting to end the police now want the police to be called as soon as violence affects them. It's a terrible, sad situation. This is brought to you by the Democrats. They thought it was good for them. Now they're realizing, we let the genie out of the bottle and now it's too much. And it'll come to a town near them eventually as well. Until force stops us, it's going to get worse and worse. So my thoughts go out to everyone, all the business owners, all the people that had to justifiably use force, all the people that were caught in the crossfire, but you thought it was cool to go out and LARP and protest and destroy buildings or stand there while people were doing it. My heart goes out to you as well, because you now have to be involved in this. You should have stayed home. You shouldn't have been encouraged to people rioting. You shouldn't have been involved in the riots. But you were. So I hope that everyone stays safe. I hope that law and order prevails. I hope that we stop burning down black business districts in the name of solving Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter. That's why I'm against the organization Black Lives Matter.